Why wait for the papers or wade through directories? If you're looking for local services or local entertainment, page your Oracle and pop into your locals.
It's that camera angle again. Can only mean one thing, another physical copy. And tonight we're going to look at RS on the PlayStation 2. Now, it's not about RS Cosworths, RS 2000s, nothing like that. Strictly two wheels, this one. Two wheels. So, yeah, totally incompetent gameplay video tonight. Really, really bad, because I just bunged the camera on, no practice. You can see the game is all there, nice and clean. I just sort of dive straight in. Let's head over and have a look. But the reason why I kind of wanted to talk about this one is because, you know, you get that kind of immediate feeling when the controls feel good. So I don't know a thing about this game. I never played it back in the day when it came out. It doesn't appear to be just another throwaway budget title. There are a couple of licenses on this one that are involved. So you've got some official licenses, so some proper bikes. But yeah, even though the gameplay from me is absolutely terrible, I got that initial feeling that, you know, a little bit of practice and this game the control mechanic feels really nice. And that's, I don't know about you, but that's a really, really difficult thing to achieve on motorbike games, which we'll talk about in a minute. But anyway, where are my manners? I hope everyone's okay. I hope everybody is okay. As you can see, we are rocking out on the Goodman's 12-volt CRT this evening. Yeah. Yeah, it's got a few issues, but given the conditions under which I rescued this poor little telly, I'm more than happy with it. So, yeah. It tends to get used mainly for kind of old TV. I'll have stuff off in the background, yeah. I'll just bung a few classic episodes of something on over this side of the room, because this is the other side of the room. When I'm doing stuff in the game room, tidying up, moving stuff around, or, you know, whatever you do, you know, pointless waste of time, but, you know, you're in your game room. So, yeah, as you can see, it's a very small TV. You can see my DVD box sets there next to it. But it's not the smallest in the collection. The other one down from this is significantly smaller. But the picture on it is quite amazing. Obviously, you get to a point where you can't really get any more out of a picture, and you're going to start losing quality the more and more you reduce the size down, just a consequence of the technology back then. But yeah, my really, really small kind of battery operated CRT, which I do use on occasion, yeah, that is quite small, but it's got a fantastic picture on it. So yeah, here we go, trying to work out what the hell I'm doing. It is only two camera options, I believe. Yeah, great start. Two camera options and, yeah, kind of analog steering, but not analog acceleration, if that makes sense. You've got a few options, but I've not really dived into the options. Is there a replay or anything else? But I'm going to spend some time with this one. But talking about the issue of bike games, a really difficult bike game, but an absolutely standout game if you're interested, is Manx TT. I've got that, but it really takes some practicing. And once you're in that zone and a penny drops and you understand it, it's brilliant. It's one of the only bike games that I know that really feels proper. You can shift your weight forward and back all at the same time, going left and right. And the brake bias and the balancing is just bang on. But guys, I'm going to spend some time with this. I need to spend some time with this one. Just before I go on the issue of bikes, possibly the worst handling bike in a game ever was on Headhunter on the Dreamcast. I never knew the point of having that element in such a good game. Headhunter, go and check it out. Guys, take care of yourselves. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.